morning to all. This is Srija, working as an assistant professor in the department of EC of St. Martin's Engineering College. Now, in this video, you will get complete information about wave propagation, topic present in antennas and wave propagation. So, let's start the topic wave propagation. So in AWP, antennas and wave propagation, we have two parts. First part is completely about antennas and its types. So it is second part about wave propagation. So in this video, I will explain about what is meant by wave propagation and what are the different types of wave propagation and what are the applications of types. Okay. So let's see the definition for wave propagation. So consider two antennas on a surface. So consider two antennas. One, first antenna is transmitting antenna. Second antenna is receiving antenna. So consider two antennas on edge surface. First one is transmitting and second one is receiving. As we already know, transmitting antenna is used for transmitting the signals into free space. Next, the receiving antenna is mainly used for receiving the signals from free space and sends same signals to respective destinations. As we already know about two antennas. But here, signal from transmitting antenna to receiving antenna can take many paths to reach the destination. So the path taken by the signal for reaching the destination is known as wave propagation. Okay? So wave propagation means just path taken by the signal to reach the destination from the transmitting antenna is known as wave propagation. So we have different types of wave propagation depending upon path taken by the signal. We have many types of wave propagation. First one is ground wave propagation. First one is ground wave propagation. Second one is sky wave propagation. Third one is tropospheric wave propagation. Fourth one is LOS propagation. Based upon path taken by the signal, we have four types of propagations. First one is ground wave propagation, second one is sky wave propagation, third one is tropospheric wave propagation, fourth one is LOS. LOS means line of sight propagation. So LOS propagation is also known as space wave propagation. LOS line of sight is also known as space wave propagation. Here sky wave propagation is also known as ionospheric wave propagation. Ionospheric wave propagation. So let's see the types of wave propagation here based upon some parameters, that is layers. Okay. So that layers I will represent in the figure. So see. Consider on its surface, we have two antennas, transmitting as well as receiving antenna. So first one, ground wave propagation. So propagation means path. So signal path near to its surface. If signal path is near to its surface, then that is known as ground wave propagation. Next. Second one, sky wave or ionospheric wave. So this ionospheric as well as star type troposphere based upon layers. As we move from edge surface to upwards, we have different types of layers like stratosphere, troposphere, ionosphere. So in our syllabus, we are considering only troposphere as well as ionosphere layer. So first, ionospheric layer as well as tropospheric layers are situated with some distance from the edge surface. So, chest and groin, tropospheric layer. Next we have ionospheric layer. So this tropospheric layer is present on the Earth surface with 16 kilometer distance. So the distance between Earth surface as well as tropospheric layer is 16 kilometer. So next, that is distance between Earth surface and ionospheric layer is 50 to 400 kilometers. So we have tropospheric layer on the Earth surface with 16 kilometer distance. Next we have ionospheric layer from the Earth surface. We have distance between ionospheric layer and Earth surface is 50 to 400 kilometers. So consider sky wave propagation. So sky wave propagation means signal path, that is from transmitting antenna to receiving antenna, is near to ionospheric layer, means that is known as ionospheric wave propagation. So signal path is near to ionospheric layer is termed as sky wave as well as ionospheric wave propagation. If signal path is near to tropospheric layer means, then that is known as tropospheric wave propagation. Okay, so we have three types. First one is ground wave. So ground wave propagation means signal path is near to Earth surface, then that is known as ground wave propagation. If signal path is near to tropospheric layer, then that is known as tropospheric wave propagation. If signal path is near to ionospheric layer, then that is known as ionospheric wave propagation. Okay. So next, one more propagation is there, that is line of sight propagation. So in line of sight propagation, signal directly goes from transmitting antenna to receiving antenna. So that is known as LOS propagation. So this figure represents types of wave propagation. Okay. This figure represents types of wave propagation. So this is about just types of wave propagation. Let's see one by one. So first one, ground wave propagation. Less than 2 MHz frequency applications we are using ground wave propagation. Okay, so this is about ground wave propagation. Mainly ground wave propagation means signal path is near to edge surface. Okay, near to edge surface, and ground acts as a perfect conductor. So ground wave propagation is mainly used for short distance as well as low frequency in the sense below 2 MHz frequency applications we are using this propagation. So next consider second propagation, that is sky wave propagation. So second one, sky wave propagation. Propagation means here we are considering ionospheric layer. Okay, ionospheric layer. Which is present at a distance 50 to 400 kilometers from the Earth surface. So the distance between Earth and ionospheric layer is 50 to 400 kilometers. So here we have two antennas, one is transmitting as well as receiving antenna. So just see the propagation of ionospheric wave. So first signal transmitting from transmitting antenna and reaches to ionospheric layer here. Okay. So when it reaches to ionospheric layer, so based upon reflection mechanism, signal is reflected back from the layer and then reaches to receiving antenna. So this propagation is known as sky wave propagation. First signal reaches to ionospheric layer, and by using reflection mechanism, it will reflected back from the layer and reaches to the receiving antenna. So this propagation is known as sky wave propagation or ionospheric wave propagation. So in this propagation, we have to consider formation of ionospheric layers. So consider same Earth surface. So ionospheric layers are divided into three types. Okay. So high layer, medium, and low layer. So formation of ions. How ions will be formed? I will explain in by using this figure. Okay. So as we already know, in sun radiates cosmic rays. So the density of cosmic rays are very high in this layer. Sun radiates cosmic layer, cosmic rays. So the density of rays are more in the case of high layer. So as we move from downwards, so density of cosmic rays will be very less in the case of low layer and medium in the case of medium layer. In the same way, we have atoms. So atoms density will be more in the case of low layer and medium in the case of medium layer, and less in the case of high layer. As we move from Earth surface to upwards, atoms density will be more. So here cosmic rays density will be more. So as we already know, ions will be formed with the combination of cosmic rays as well as atoms. So compared to atoms and cosmic rays, so density of ions will be more in case of medium layer, because here we have medium number of cosmic rays as well as medium number of atoms. Here we have more number of cosmic rays and less number of atoms. Here we have less number of cosmic rays and more number of atoms. So by comparing all these layers, we have more number of ions in medium layer. So sky wave propagation is mainly used for high frequency applications. Sky wave propagation is mainly used for high frequency application, that is 3 MHz to 30 MHz frequency applications. If we send signal more than 30 MHz, it will not reflect it from the ionospheric layer, because it consists of less number of ions. So its maximum range is 30 MHz only. Okay, if we send high frequency than 30 MHz, purpose, sky wave propagation is mainly used for high frequency range, that is 3 to 30 only. So above 30 MHz frequency applications, we can use space wave propagation. Space wave. So this is about types of wave propagations. Thank you all. Thank you.